Wubba Lubba Dub Dub, season 5 is coming, Morty. It's coming, and you better be ready for some fan theories as tasty as some Mulan Szechuan sauce. But for us here at Screen Rant, it's not coming quite quick enough, and the wait is making us more frustrated than a Meeseeks trying to help Jerry's golf game. In this video, we'll check out 5 different theories circulating the internet right now, and how they all serve as some sort of prediction for season 5, including identity reveals for major characters, the return of old foes, and one theory that is just so crazy that it just might work. Fire up the portal guns because we are going back to the world of Rick and Morty.
So many possibilities.
My mind is racing.
One of the biggest mysteries and or cliffhangers Adult Swim presented us in Rick and Morty was the reveal that there are two Beths operating in the same dimension. This was teased earlier in the season when Rick presented Beth with a choice that meant she could either stay with her family on Earth or have a clone temporarily replace her and allow her to go on her own adventures and have her own spin-off show, The Adventures of Space Beth. Yeah, I'm just kidding about that last bit, but I would like to see it. We don't actually learn what Beth chooses, and it's left seemingly unresolved. That is, until the season finale, where we see that there are two Beths. The issue is, we don't know which one is the real Beth and which one is the clone. They also don't know which one is which, and to make matters worse, neither does the man who created them both, Rick. But what have the writers had to say? Well, co-creator Dan Harmon has said that we are currently in a state of Schrodinger's Beth, what a term, where both are the original and both are the clone. But he seemingly stated that which one is which will be revealed in the upcoming season. Both are alive, alive I tell you, but that doesn't help figure out which one is which.
I am alive, alive I tell you!
Some suggestions doing the rounds right now is that Space Beth is actually the clone Beth, because she is labeled as such on the Pokemon parody game Pocket Morty. Gotta catch them all. Also, we see a blue streak in Space Beth's hair, an Easter egg to Evil Britta in Dan Harmon's show Community. Also, this isn't based on evidence, but being a loving matriarch, Beth may not want to abandon her children and leave them to be raised by a clone Beth, Jerry, because let's face it, Jerry, and even worse, Rick. But let's look at it this way for a moment. Beth has had to endure a lot in her life, an estranged relationship with her father who abandoned her, a dysfunctional marriage with Jerry, and a life which has kept her trapped while she watched Rick, Morty, and Summer go off on a series of adventures. Beth needs her own time in the sun. We know that she's wanted to break out of her entrapment from the beginning, and it is a nice thought to think that she would have taken it. Plus, it could be a case of father like daughter. Rick left the family for his own reasons. Maybe Beth did the same. There's no evidence to support this theory, but it feels like a route that Harmon and Justin Roiland might go down. But we'll have to wait and see. This next one's a mystery that has kept fans guessing and waiting for a while now. And that is, of course, the only Morty ever to shake off his meekness and pose a threat to Rick. The Morty who fans call Evil Morty. Now, after his brief appearance in Never Ricking Morty, some fans have become discouraged that Evil Morty is actually going to have some weight in the plot. But we, like many, are still holding out for the long game, and believe that somewhere down the line, Evil Morty's identity and true intentions will be revealed. But what are the theories as to the identity of this malicious Morty? One of the funniest but strangely possible theories is that Evil Morty is actually the counterpart for Doofus Rick, and makes up for Doofus Rick intellect by having the same level of genius as your bog standard Rick. Another theory is that Evil Morty is the one that Rick and Morty kill after they escape the Cronenberg planet in the episode Rick Potion, and that maybe Morty didn't actually die, but survived and is seeking revenge. But the most popular theory suggests that Morty is actually the real Morty from C-137. It would mean that the Morty we see is an imposter, and that Evil Morty is the one that existed before this Morty. The one that went wrong and the one that Rick feels guilty about. Potentially the real reason he is in so much pain and says his trademark catchphrase. Is there evidence to support this? Well, kind of. In one episode, we see Evil Rick going through Rick's memories and finding one where he's playing with an adorable toddler Morty. As well as this, in the episode Get Swifty while visiting Bird Person, Morty notices a photo of Rick holding a young Morty. On its own, this is not evidence at all. It's barely even relevant and is more of a stretch than, I don't know, Captain Fantastic reaching for his keys that he dropped in the sewer. But in context, it makes sense. Huh? That's because Rick had been absent for 20 years and, seeing as Morty is 14, would presumably not have been around for his early life. But why does Rick have these memories? Why is he pictured with a young Morty? What are you not telling us, Rick? Tell me, where are the other Mortys? Did you put your name in the Goblet of Fire? Sorry, got a bit carried away there, but it does seriously pose the question, is Rick hiding something? And is evil Morty the original and have a legitimate reason to hate Rick? Or has all of this just been a giant red Mr. Meeseeks? The fact that Morty is not the original Morty plays into our next theory, that none of the original characters are the ones that we see on screen. As you know, C-137 was abandoned by Rick and Morty after the emergence of Cronenberg monsters, meaning that a number of characters were left behind. We do see them again, but what this episode showed is that the show has no qualms over cutting original characters and swapping them, which when you have a never-ending series of dimensions, it does make sense. But something that supports this episode is that we see another Rick and Morty in action, but at first we don't necessarily realize it. In the episode Morty Night Run, they drop off their Jerry at Jerrybury and are given the ticket 5126. Later on in the episode, we see Rick and Morty return to claim their Jerry, and as they leave, we see another Rick asking if they have 5126, meaning we have been following another Rick and Morty the whole time. This means that at almost any point in the series, we cannot be fully sure that the Rick and Morty we are witnessing are actually the same ones that we started off with, and we don't know if every episode we see is actually canon or part of the timeline of the original Rick and Morty. This also coincides with the title sequence, which involves a bunch of adventures that we don't get to see in the show. So by the end of the show's run, if not already, the Rick and Morty we know and love may not be the ones that we started off with. That's if we ever did start with both originals. Man, this is making my head hurt. One of the consistent thorns in Rick's side have been the Galactic Federation, who have served as one of the main antagonists for Rick in the show. The Federation showed their villainy when their undercover agent Tammy fabricated a wedding to Bird Person so they could set a trap for Rick, with Tammy murdering Bird Person in a moment that was so soul-crushing, you'd think it came out of Game of Thrones. Rick seemingly gets the best of the Federation in Season 3, but being the scourge of the universe, they of course make their return in Season 4 with the evil and despicable Tammy. Ugh, I hate you, Tammy, I hate you. But Rick again gets the best of them, defeating them once again and sending them back to whence they came. But as they say, no one's ever really gone, which could lead to the Galactic Federation's return, making them the new Galactic Federation, or possibly the artist formerly known as the Galactic Federation, whichever one is more catchy. Rick may have defeated them again, but I still imagine that, like Batman, they're out there operating in the shadows and will soon make a devastating comeback and possibly kill off another fan favorite. Just saying, but they better leave Jerry the hell alone. Let's end this video with a bang, shall we? As I said before, there are a lot, and I do mean a lot, of fan theories doing the rounds out there, and they often fall into either the good, bad, or the ugly category. A theory that I can't figure out where to place though is one that certainly feels like a stretch in a video where we have stretched quite a bit, but it's impossible to ignore, and that is the theory that Rick and Morty are one and the same. This theory has been around for some time now, but as we mentioned, it will not go away. And the theory suggests that Rick is a grown-up Morty who has traveled back in time to look after and protect his younger self. In fact, some have even gone so far as to say that Rick is stuck in a time loop, hence why he is so bitter and in so much pain, as he knows where his life is headed. But it poses a lot of problems. Firstly, their personalities and intelligence are very, very far apart, and while personalities may somewhat change, it's hard to imagine Morty becoming a genius later on in his life, unless some miraculous event happened to him. Also, it doesn't account for the numerous Rick and Mortys out there who all have the exact same relationship. How Beth and Summer work into this dynamic is a complete unknown, and I feel like overall, it would create some type of paradox. It's an imaginative theory, I'll give it that, but I think it's a little bit outlandish. Even for a show where dogs become sentient, there's a character called Mr. Poopy Butthole, and of course, Pickle Rick!
Boom! Big reveal, I'm a pickle! What do you think about that? I turned myself into a pickle!
What did you make of these theories? What do you want to see happen? Looking forward to Season 5? Let us know in the comments below and make sure to subscribe to the channel today for more Rick and Morty content. See ya!